Mr. Thunder Jr., Frank Murphy from Alhekin.
Glad to know you, Frank. I'd shake your hand, but the bones in my wrist are dust.
Okay. So, the 747 flies in from Syracuse first thing tomorrow. As soon as it's fumigated, we're gonna put it...
Oh, let me guess. Between the ramps? Look, just set that fucking pig down and I'll give you a shit show this fuck town will never forget. Understood?
Loud and clear. Well, if that's all, I better get back home and go...
Oh, this evening ain't over by a damn sight. I don't like to drink alone. I do it all the time, but I don't like it. This is my favorite kind of beer. And my hand. Frank, you're barely binge drinking. Something wrong?
Nothing. I'm fine.
Come on. Lean on me, brother.
Well, we just passed the hospital where my father died. Be honest, I went through a real rough spot after that. That was a fucking mess. But getting you to do this jump is gonna get me a big bonus. And I think that's what my dad was trying to tell me when he died. That work gives your life value. You think that could be true?
I'm sorry, did you say something? I can't hear out of my right ear.
I was saying my dad died!
Feeling low, huh? Well, I only know one way to take them blues away, partner.
What are you doing?
You gotta let that shit go, Frank.
All right, the shit has been let go. Shit has been let go. No more blues. No more blues.
Yeehaw!
Shit!
Dinner and a hat.
It's Christmas in July and December.
Christmas Eve with Jim Neighbors and the Mormon Tabernacle Choir will not be seen today, so that we may bring you this ABS Sports special presentation.
Live from Rust Belt Memorial Airport and parking lot, White House Beer and Dippity Doo present Buster Thunder Jr. 'Twas the Jump Before Christmas. And a pleasant Christmas Eve to you all. In just 1 hour, Buster Thunder Jr. will attempt to make his first successful jump of the 1970s by soaring over a Boeing 747, courtesy of Alhekin Airlines.
No fucking way Buster makes it! Look at me! I'm on the TV box! Woo!
Dave, these are the kind of simple, unread people that can swing an election.
Make me proud to be an American.
Frank? He's not supposed to be unconscious until after the jump.
Ed, he told me this was part of his pre-jump ritual. Just leave him be.
Okay, but he doesn't appear to be breathing.
Get skull fucked, little man.
I just met Buster Thunder Jr.
Oh, there's the chairman of the board. His ass isn't gonna kiss itself.
Hot pretzels, splatter ponchos, leftover roast beef my wife made last night!
Mom, these seats are incredible.
This is a better view than the one we had when that statue guy blew up.
All right, it's a party.
You're gonna get to see an ambulance with all those pretty little lights go.
Frank! David!
Hey, guys! Gonna get that bonus! Love you!
I love you too, Frank Murphy!
Santa did read my letter.
Hey, beautiful. California, here we come.
I left a note for the boys under the Christmas tree. They're Greg's problem now. I'm finally free.
and I'm going back to my maiden name. Goodbye, Jenny's Rotor. Welcome back, Jenny Dykefister.
Ah, this backseat is so lumpy. That's what you get when you buy from Tojo.
Oh, she's coming too.
She's my ma. We live with her.
It's the pedal on the right. Get driving, little Miss Mustache.
She's gone. She's really gone. I will never forget the 6 million seconds I spent with her.
Don't you dare roll down that window. I'm cold.
It was nice seeing you play your music for those cute little babies.
Yeah, it rocked, huh? I would have gotten a standing ovation, but they can't stand up yet.
Kevin, I like when you pretend to be stupid.
Yeah, you're right. I'm smart as shit.
Hey, guys. You remember Kevin, right? He pissed off an entire community of Jews?
Yeah. I'm real sorry about all that. How's your jaw?
I have to drink hamburgers through a straw now.
No way. They make that? You must be really good at sucking.
Kevin, it's Christmas Eve. Shouldn't you be at home terrorizing your family?
They're all down at the airport to watch the Buster Thunder jump my dad set up.
Yes. Driving a motorcycle over a jumbo jet. Sounds like someone has some unresolved childhood issues.
Yeah, and balls. It's on Channel 9 if you want to watch.
Well, I guess I could watch for research purposes. You know, I'm working on a book about male bravado. It's called The Caveman Who Sighed. The cover is a satirical drawing of...
Dad, we're gonna go talk in my room.
Okay, Peanut. Now, I trust you'll use your best judgment and... Oh, no way he's gonna make that.
Here you go, Mr. Prescott. Right up front with a great view of the landing ramp, just behind the Bloodmobile.
Yeah, splendid. Good job, Murphy.
Thanks. And can I say that I am so grateful that you like my idea and...
Murphy, where can I get a scotch and soda around here?
Well, all we have is a beer tent. I can get you one.
Excellent. And let's get some for the whole board.
Oh, yeah, I'll have one. Sounds good. Perfect.
Are you going to give me the money now or when I, It's on me. Shit.
Mr. Mayor, nice to meet you for the first time.
It is nice to meet you as well, having never seen you before. And depending on how this goes, maybe not even now.
Thanks for making sure my union boys got the construction job on this. We saved the mint by not using nuts on the speaker towers. Bolts, yes, nuts, no. If you know what I mean.
I do know what you mean, if you know what I mean.
There they are, fucking crooks.
They won't know what hit them when we skin them alive. Skin. I used to love that word.
You get me in that TV truck and I'll slip in my hidden camera tape showing Gagliardi bribing the mayor. I was all set to air it last year, but the mayor got wind of it and destroyed my reputation by concocting that whole pregnancy fetish about me.
So you ain't freaky for late bitches?
Pure fiction.
Keep them coming.
Jesus, did your wife leave you?
Why does everyone always ask me that? I'm trying to get my boss drunk. It's called business.
Uncle Lewis, I'm so glad you're back with us.
Me too, buddy.
Do you barge into people's houses and announce yourself, like Bruce again does?
Oh, honey, if you want to see real gay people on television, go watch Bert and Ernie.
As we near the 30-minute mark, let's hear a number from those clean-cut kids from the heartland. Harmo Nation!
Hey, everyone! We are America's youth!
The USA is A-OK, from the DMV to the CIA, we
love. Why would anyone listen to Led Zeppelin when they could rock out to this?
Wow, Vic, this ad is great. It'll really help my business get going.
I know. Once this runs in the paper, you'll be choking on babies.
Is that a good thing?
For this metaphor, it is.
Okay, Rosie, now we break into the truck. If anyone tries to stop us, I'll simply explain I'm the van inspector.
You crazy? What makes you think anybody would believe a half-assed explanation like... Oh, right. You're white.
You know, that's what's wrong with you blacks. You make everything about race.
Oh, fuck you, Pogo. After we do this, I'm through with you.
Well, well, well. If it isn't the stuck pig that wiggled off the rotisserie.
Well, now you've made me hungry.
and this is, I want to say, your driver?
I'm a city alderman, motherfucker!
Between the garbage and the shitters, right where you belong.
I'm not afraid of you, Mr. Mayor.
That's Mr. Mayor to you.
I tell you, Dave, the thought of a white man not obeying any laws of safely operating a motorized vehicle reminds me of why all those who lived here freely before we arrived were destroyed.
Right you are, Ernst.
Well, that was breakfast. Time to suit up. The foot? The ramps are on the ends. That pig is supposed to be sideways.
Oh, yes. It highlights our logo for the TV cameras. The A is for Alahican.
Well, I can't jump that.
Your manager agreed to it.
My manager is my ex-wife. She gets half of everything. Hell, she'd say yes to having me jump two lines fucking a crocodile. I'm gone.
Something wrong?
Frank, can you jump a motorcycle?
No, I can't, Ed.
And something is very wrong.
Aw, oh, shit.
So, what have you been up to?
Not much. Just spending most of my time writing songs for babies. I'm actually working on a rock opera about diaper rash. You know, you breaking up with me, it really gave me some time to think. And I realized that maybe, like, I'm not ready to be in anything serious right now. And I'm totally cool with just being friends with you. Or not.
Buster! Don't do this to me. This whole thing is to promote Alahican. If we don't get the logo on TV, then what's the point?
The point? The point is to watch a mythical man with a dick longer than your neck defy death and show you indoor living juice drinkers that you don't have to marry the first harlot that gives you a piece of pie.
I can't argue with that.
I gotta dump my toilet. Where do you guys fish around here?
Buster, please! I got everything riding on this. This job is all I have. If you don't do this jump and save the airline, then I'm nobody.
You're somebody, all right. You're a fucking corporate flunky.
I don't know what I'm gonna do.
God, you're pathetic. No wonder your dad died. Fine. I'll jump your pig, little man. I won't remember any of it tomorrow anyways.
Whoa, hey, where you going? You're not supposed to jump for another 21 minutes.
You want your fucking jump? I'm doing it now. See you on the other side.
Ah, shit.
Staying positive keeps us on our feet.
Last words?
You know what? Go ahead and shoot me. Put a bullet in me if you want. You can kill me, but you can't kill what I stand for. And your time is running out. I will not beg for my life. I'm a man, and I don't grovel to rats.
Are you gonna take that from him? I say we shoot him, eh, Goombas?
Man, fuck you, Pogo!
Okay, that's it!
Oh! Right in the Gordon.
Do you have a rubber?
Oh, thank God I set that fire at your temple. Oh, I got this from the truck at work.
You have a job?
I did, yeah, for a couple hours. And then my boss started crying.
Hey, look, Daddy's part of the show.
What the? No, no, Frank, commercial.
Fuck off.
Commercial.
Yeah, Frank, keep shining like the star you are.
I wish I was dead.
Buster is going to jump a full 20 minutes ahead of schedule.
Network TV rules mean nothing to the man.
Holy Mussolini, Philip, we got to see you this
summer. One time I decide to shit indoors.
You and your fucking nuts.
Rosie, look out!
We interrupt this commercial because Buster Thunder Jr. is jumping now.
Honcho's out, kids!
No, thanks. I want to feel it hit my fist.
shall be my Sistine Chapel.
Please, God, please let that long dick bastard make it to the other ramp in your name.
He did it, Ed! He did it! The crazy bastard did it!
I am Rock Hart.
Here comes the airplane.
That fucking maniac, he made it!
Dad!
Never come near my daughter again, you Gentile piece of shit!
I didn't do anything! You scared me and made me miss!
Bye, Kevin! See you in school!
Yeah! Hey, Bob, you saved my life.
You deserve it. You're a good man. And I'm gonna be a better man. From now on, Rosie, I swear, I've got a happy life to look forward to.
But you're paralyzed. You spend the rest of your life
in a chair. A wonderful chair. It's my dream come true. Can I get one of those feeding tubes?
Buster, you finally landed a jump. How do you feel?
Well, Ernie, when I was up there sailing over that pig, I had time to think. I saw you folks cheering me on. TV cameras, the whole world watching, and it hit me. I hate my fucking life.
Ah, oh, Jesus.
Look what I am. A clown that has to make a living. Almost getting my guts smeared all over an airplane for a bunch of fucking ghouls with tiny little lives on the night before our Lord and Savior shot out of his holy mother's cooch. Because let me tell you something, Rustvale.
Yeah, Rustvale! Rustvale!
I'm done entertaining you pinheads.
Oh.
Find some other asshole to fill up your afternoon in this eyesore of a town with your ugly women and mediocre cuisine.
He's not wrong about the cuisine.
Buster! Thunder Jr., everybody! Okay, let's have a nice
The only reason I did this jump is because this sorry sack of shit put on a dress and started crying about how he wouldn't get promoted to junior vice ass licker at this crash and burn airline. Oh, yeah, and I'm a quarter Cherokee, so fuck Allahakin too!
Why would we pay him to say that?
By the way, every city I go to, I make sure I fuck at least one guy's wife. This town was no different. Enjoy your ride home.
We wish you a Merry Christmas. We wish you a Merry Christmas. We wish you a Merry Christmas and a Happy
Frank, join us. Open your gifts.
Oh, what's the point? I didn't get my bonus. They demoted me to lower management. Christ, it's the same job, half my pay.
Well, work didn't bring me happiness, Dad!
And now, back to a Colt Luger Christmas.
Ah, now you just stop talking. Let me enjoy the one treasure I have left in life.
When I took out the Escobar gang, I killed your fathers. Killed them all. Now it's your turn. Get ready to eat hot fudge. Because I'm gonna buy a lettuce farm and raise you kids as my very own. Merry Christmas.
Ah, the whole world's gone to hell. Another fucking year and more disappointment. You know what? Shoot me, Colt. Put me out of my misery.
That's enough of your poor me bullshit.
What did I do?
Frank Murphy, this family supported you these past few weeks when all you could do was talk about Buster Thunder. So it didn't work out. And now you blame him for your shitty mood. There's always somebody to blame. Bob Pogo or Roger Dumbarton.
Grandma Nora.
The Beatles.
Johnny Unitas at one time.
Now, Bill, I've told you 1,000 times that was Earl Morrill's fault. Christ's sake, they put Unitas in at the end of the game. He almost pulled it out. Shit, if they put him in earlier, like they should have, they would have won instead of losing to Joe Willie Namath, that pantyhose-wearing fucking jackass. What? It's true.
But your favorite person to blame is your father. Well, he's not here. But we are. All we want is to have a nice Christmas as a family. But you chose to mope around all day.
It's not my choice, Susan! Life decides!
Nice going, Frank. Hell of a first Christmas for your daughter.
Maybe I should take a drive or something. Clear my head.
Nobody here is stopping you.
It is with a heavy heart that I resign my position as your mayor.
Yes!
Tangenti was arrested and charged with accessory to attempted murder. He will also be charged with bribery, thanks to explosive undercover video provided by our own Jim Jeffords.
Boo!
The Valachi Tollway has been canceled, along with all city projects linked to the late union boss Lou Gagliardi. The Tangenti era is over. Never has this city seen such a catastrophic fall from grace.
Jim, I seem to remember you.
No, that's it. Now on to sports.
Well, Georgia, there is a Santa Claus, and he's black. We're saved!
Yeah, let me get a shorty, too.
It's on me, Walt.
Thanks, Dick.
What's got you staring at the bottom of a glass on this fine Christmas morning?
My wife and kids can't stand the sight of me. How about you?
I lost a game of euchre to my granddaughter and told her to go fuck herself. Thanks again for that beautiful funeral for Big Bill. He would have loved it.
You know, I'm glad you liked him, but I'm getting tired of hearing about a guy I spent my whole life hating. I mean, he barges back into my life and forces me to rethink everything. And just when it looks like we're gonna figure it all out, he dies and drops some shit about Box 16 in my lap.
Good old Box 16.
You know what it is?
Oh, yeah. Sure.
I've spent the last 2 months trying to figure out what the fuck that means. I must have looked through every box in the city.
Box? No. It's Bach. Johann Sebastian Bach. The music guy with the faggy wig. Box Prelude and Fugue number 16. It was your dad's favorite piece of music.
He was telling me about music? Why that? Was it important to his life?
That was the jingle for White House Beer. Used to be on the radio all the time in the 30s. Have a beer, drink a beer, want a beer, White House Beer. He'd sing it when he'd come in here and get plastered. A lot of times on Christmas. Just like you, how about that? He always said he wanted to play it at his funeral. Be good for a chuckle, he'd say. Ah, jeez. I'm sorry if you thought that it meant something more than that.
Perfect. Perfect. Of all the things he could have said to me when he was dying, he puts in a song request. That selfish son of a bitch.
It wasn't all bad. He just didn't know how to be a dad.
How fucking hard is it to not be an asshole to your own kid?
Well, you're here drinking on Christmas, so you tell me.
Christmas, Dad. We're done.
Ah, shit. Here comes Scrooge McDick. Act sad so he doesn't take our Christmas presents.
Hey, Billy. How you doing, Philip?
He didn't tell me to go fuck myself. Maybe he's sick.
I would say he's drunk, but usually that just makes him meaner.
So, did it dawn on you that it's Christmas?
I found out what box 16 means.
Really?
It means my parents were two messed up people who fucked and made me. And nothing more. That's something to build on.
Yeah.
Ah, Sue, I'm so sorry. You were right. You're always right. From now on, I'm just gonna listen to you, instead of daredevils, angry candymen, psycho Air Force pilots, hookers at wakes.
That's a start.
Right now, I'd just love to have a nice Christmas with my family, if that's okay.
I made pigs in blankets with your favorite vegetable, mustard.
God, I love you. Everyone, something I want to tell you. The last year or so has been very hard for me. And that means it's been harder for you. Well, I learned something about myself today. I learned that if you...
Here we go.
Let's see.
What if they're calling from work? It might be important.
Nah, this is important.
Is he having a stroke or am I?
Watch it.
He's a little comedian.
I'm funny too.
Yeah, but looks and smells don't count.
You're so dead.
Well, slack on your studies, Bill. Stan earn a living making people laugh.
You're not gonna get me, you son of a bitch.